Hello everyone, today we will discuss on important current affairs of 26th January. You can download PDF from the link given in the description of this video. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon. Let's start. First question. Who has been appointed as MD and CEO of Canara Bank? Answer is Lingam Venkat Prabhakar. Government appointed Lingam Venkat Prabhakar as MD and CEO of Canara Bank. This is with effect from 1st February 2020. He is currently serving as Executive Director in Punjab National Bank. What are the other important appointments in banking sector recently? This we discussed in our previous video as well. Sanjeev Chadha was appointed as MD and CEO of Bank of Baroda. Atanu Kumar Das was appointed as MD and CEO of Bank of India. Challa Srinivasulu Shetty was appointed as Managing Director of SBI. Next question. Government announced how many Padma Awards on the eve of 71st Republic Day? Right answer is 141 awards. Government announced 141 Padma Awards, which includes Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan and Padma Vibhushan. This time 7 Padma Vibhushan, 16 Padma Bhushan and 118 Padma Shri Awards were announced, out of which 34 awardees are women and 18 foreigners. 12 persons are awarded posthumously. What is the meaning of posthumously? It means they are being awarded after their death. Former Union Minister George Fernandez, Sushma Swaraj and Arun Jaitley will be awarded Padma Vibhushan posthumously. The Padma Awards are one of the highest civilian honours of India, announced annually on the eve of Republic Day to recognize achievements in all fields where public service is involved. These awards were started in 1954. Next question. Government signed a loan agreement of $210 million with which international financial institution to support agriculture? Answer is World Bank. Government of India along with Government of Maharashtra has signed an agreement with World Bank for a loan amount of $210 million to support agriculture. This loan is for the project Maharashtra Agribusiness and Rural Transformation Project. Through this project, the government will support the smallhold farmers to make them competitive, productive in all the districts of Maharashtra. How many districts Maharashtra have? 36 districts. Where is the headquarter of World Bank? It is in Washington, D.C. Who is the current president of World Bank? David R. Malpass. When was the World Bank founded? It was in 1944. Also remember, Chief Minister of Maharashtra is Uddhav Thackeray and Governor is Bhagat Singh Koshyari. Next question. India's first war memorial for animals is said to be built in which city? Answer is Meerut. A war memorial will be built in Meerut, Uttar Pradesh for animals. This memorial will feature a heroine who lost her life in a counter-insurgency operation in Kashmir in 2016. This memorial will also feature some other animals which lost their lives in the Kargil war in 1999. It will be India's first animal war memorial. The names and service numbers of over 350 handlers, 300 dogs and a few horses and mules will be inscribed on granite tablets at this memorial. Who is the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh? Yogi Adityanath. Next question. When is National Tourism Day observed every year? Answer is 25th January. National Tourism Day is celebrated on 25th January in India every year to raise awareness about the importance of tourism for the country's economy, because tourism generates a lot of revenue to the economy. National Tourism Day is on 25th January. When is World Tourism Day celebrated? It is on 27th September. Remember, National Tourism Day is on 25th January and World Tourism Day is celebrated on 27th September. Who is the Union Minister of State for Tourism and Culture? Sri Prahlad Singh Patel. Next question. What is India's rank in Corruption Perception Index which was released recently? Answer is 88th rank. India's rank in Corruption Perception Index is 80. According to this index, Denmark is in the top of the list. A total of 180 countries were ranked in this index. Who released these rankings? Transparency International. Transparency International is a non-governmental organization. It was established in 1993 and it is headquartered in Berlin, Germany. India's previous rank was 78 and now it is 80. Next question. Which country has assumed the chairmanship of Group of 77 recently? Right answer is Guyana. Guyana has took over the chairmanship of Group of 77 for 2020. India is also a member of the G77. G77 was established by 77 developing countries in 1964 at Geneva, Switzerland. Remember, it was founded at Geneva, Switzerland, but its headquarters is in New York, United States. At present, it has 134 member countries. The Group of 77 is the largest intergovernmental organization of developing countries in the United Nations. Where is the headquarters of United Nations? It is in New York. When was it founded? It was founded in 1945. And now we'll have a look at the capital and currency of Guyana. Capital of Guyana is Georgetown and its currency is Guyanese dollar. Next question. Which state government has made reading of preamble of constitution on every Saturday in schools is mandatory? Right answer is Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh government has made the reading of preamble of the constitution mandatory in schools on every Saturday. The preamble to the constitution will be read out by the headmaster or teacher of all the schools after prayer on every Saturday. The same will be read out by the students later. The preamble of the constitution is a brief introductory statement that sets out guidelines which guide the people of the nation. Next question. Which bank has recently launched wealth management platform Pioneer Banking? Right answer is IndusInd Bank. IndusInd Bank has launched its wealth management platform called Pioneer Banking, which serves the banking needs of its high net worth customers. It means a pioneer can be a person having a savings account or current account with an average quarterly balance of rupees 10 lakh and above. IndusInd Bank is a private bank established in 1994 and its headquarters is in Mumbai, Maharashtra. Next question. World Archery has removed suspension on which of the following countries' archery association recently? Answer is India. The World Archery conditionally lifted the suspension on India due to India's suspension earlier. Indian archers were not allowed to compete at the Asian Championships under the Indian flag. They had to compete as neutral athletes. The next international archery tournament is Indoor World Series in Las Vegas in February 2020. Remember, Arjun Munda was elected as the new president of Indian Archery Association recently. These elections were conducted in the presence of an observer from the World Archery. What is his name? Qazi Razib Uddin Ahmad Chapal. Remember, Qazi Razib Uddin Ahmad Chapal. These are the important current affairs of 26th January. Please hit a like if the content is helpful. Thank you.